Hi everyone, welcome to another part of our series, April Stress Awareness Month. And in our series, we are now on the pathway to peace, embracing new approaches to stress awareness. Now, because this vlog is very long, I needed to break it up in a part one and a part two. So just so that you don't get confused, part one is about is going to be step one and step two that concentrates or focuses on mindfulness, mindful mornings, morning or evening, depending on your lifestyle. And then step two is digital detox. Part two will focus on cultivating gratitude, embracing movement, and then seeking support if need be. Now, this is a five-step program to either alleviate or manage stress. Stress is not going to disappear. So don't misunderstand the series. It's about managing stress and it's about alleviating the stress, making it more controllable in your daily life and having a balanced and a value-adding lifestyle. That's what it's about. Start your day or end your evening with a mindful morning or evening routine. To set a positive tone for the day or to end your day positively. Instead of reaching for your phone immediately when you're waking up. Or sleeping with your phone in your hand or going to bed with your phone in your hand and sleeping. Take a few minutes to engage in an activity that promotes calmness and clarity. This could include gentle stretching, deep breathing, we spoke about breathing before, exercises, or just a brief meditation session by starting your day with intention and mindfulness. You can cultivate a sense of peace and resilience that will help you navigate stress or stresses more effectively. Now, if you choose to do it in the morning or in the evening, it's on you, dependent your day schedule. But whether it's a morning routine, whether it's an evening routine, the focus should be on becoming mindful and just releasing stress. Not beginning your day with anxiety or ending your day with worry. Step two, digital detox. Okay, this is difficult and a challenge for me as well. Digital detox, because my whole life revolves around digital. Right. But let's dive into it. Let's give it a try. Let's not just, no way I'm putting my cell phone down. No way I'm leaving my laptop or my tablet or my iPhone or my TV. No way I'm not going to binge watch the series or whatever. Let's just hear this out and see if you can give it a try. If you can incorporate it at least once a week or once a month into your daily, into your lively routine. Let me put it like that. So, yeah, digital detox. That is a crucial, very important one, actually. Take regular breaks from technology to reduce digital overwhelmness and restore mental clarity, right? Set boundaries around your use of devices and designate specific time throughout the day to disconnect and engage in offline activities. Use this time to connect with nature, spend quality time with loved ones, or pursue hobbies that bring you joy. By prioritizing offline experiences, you can reduce stress and cultivate a greater sense of balance in your life. I'm going to dive into digital detox again, because I don't think we are finished with digital detox. I was surprised when I did my research to find out that digital detox is actually step two, not step one. Step one is to prepare to help you, like, log off from your, you know, surrounding, your environment. And step two is now you put, once you've done that, you're now able to log off or log off, yes, from digital, or do a digital detox. And you see, this flow, if you do it in these steps, it will make it easier for you. It will help alleviate stress. It's not going to take stress away, please. It's not going to take stress away, but it's going to decrease a bit of the stress, or make stress more manageable, or bring you to a more balanced you in an environment that you may be, that you may find difficult, being it a work environment, being it domestically home environment, being it a social environment, you know, being it a spiritual environment, whichever environment you find difficult and where the stress is lying, educational environment, career environment, you know, there's a lot of type of environments that we haven't even touched that we think is healthy, but it causes stress. But we're going to dive into digital detox a little bit more in depth later on. But for now, let's just brief it just like that.